a coffin left on Congressman Russ Carnahan's front lawn, or wasn't there?
The heat of the health care debate sent accusations flying today. In fact, a headline in USA Today reads, "Death Threat or Peaceful Vigil?" Fox News' Betsy Bruce tracked down the coffin and has the real story. Betsy?
Well, Tom, St. Louis Tea Party members dismayed by the new health care legislation turned to political theater this weekend to make their points. That's how a stage prop coffin made the national news stage. Political protest. It's a time-honored American tradition. And St. Louisans on both sides of the national health care debate are making sure they are being heard.
We're here in front of Congressman Russ Carnahan's house to have a solemn ceremony for the loss of freedom that we lost today in a vote in Congress.
Sunday, members of the St. Louis Tea Party group added some political theater to their vigil, protesting passage of the health care bill, using this stage coffin as a prop.
We brought with us Sunday to Congressman Carnahan's office and then to his house and then brought back here as a symbol of lost freedom and potentially lost lives due to government health care rationing.
News stories surfaced Thursday morning suggesting the protesters had left the coffin on the congressman's lawn. In light of other alleged and real political threats this week, the story grew, but the coffin was in Hennessy's garage.
It was never out of our possession, ever, 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 for a moment.
Tea Party members hit their blogs questioning the congressman's motives.
To say that it was left in his lawn it's a misrepresentation. It didn't happen.
Local Carnahan spokeswoman Sarah Howard tried to smooth the rough waters.
I don't think that the congressman interpreted this as a threat, but I think that taken in the context of what's going on around the country, some of the alarming things that you're seeing images of nooses being faxed to members' offices, death threats against members' children, I think that people are looking at things like this and asking what is it that they were trying to communicate.
Now, both sides, locally and nationally, are condemning this kind of rhetoric and calling for civil discussions about their differences. Betsy Bruce, Fox 2 News.